Hey everyone, welcome back to Sharing with Charlotte. My name is Charlotte. If you're new here, welcome. If you've seen my videos before, welcome back. Today, we're gonna be talking about five quotes that you can use and remember to guide yourself into forgiveness when you're having a rough day, when your thoughts are getting carried away. So before we get into the five quotes, I just wanted to take this moment and land in the present moment. I found it to be extremely beneficial, especially when we are always thinking, always doing, always thinking about what we should be doing. We can just take this moment to just anchor in with our breath, land in this moment. There's nowhere else you're supposed to be. You're here to learn and thank yourself for being here and just give yourself a hug. And the more compassion we can give to ourselves, the more compassion we can give to others. So take a moment to hug yourself and let's get into the five quotes that can guide you into forgiveness. Okay, I have my notebook here. So number one, life is full of ups and downs and things are going to happen that you never saw coming. Darkness leads us to light. A part of being alive means that we're going to experience ups and downs. Maybe herpes wasn't something that you saw coming for your life, and that's completely okay. I believe that we all have this like blueprint of what we want for our lives. If you haven't downloaded my Align Guide, head over to my website, join my mailing list, and I'll send you the Align Guide. It talks all about the soul blueprint and how before we come to Earth, we've designed this blueprint for our lives. And I personally believe that herpes was on my blueprint, and it's here to teach me a lesson. Once we become human, we also have a different blueprint for our lives. I don't think herpes is ever on someone's blueprint. It's not something that someone says they want or that they're excited for or that they plan to get. When I got herpes, maybe when you got herpes, that's why it was like, it was so hard for me to accept because it was never on my blueprint. It was never something I wanted. I feel like when we can remember that life is about ups and downs and really just being accepting of what happens in our lives and being non-judgmental with ourselves and being compassionate and like understanding that we're human at the end of the day and that herpes happens to humans, I think that can be super helpful to remember. There's a siren, so we'll wait. Okay, I think it's gone. Number two, change is the only constant. And I bring this up to remind you that we're always changing and herpes is a change that happened. Part of forgiveness, I feel like, is really accepting change and forgive yourself for the changes that you go through and forgive yourself again for being human. Drop it in the comments, hashtag being freaking human, because at the end of the day, change is the only constant and we need to make friends with change. Number three, everything happens for your greater evolution. If you've watched my videos before, I'm sure you've heard me say that we are each a soul having a human experience in Earth School. It's a quote from Gary Zukav that I absolutely love. We're a soul that's on Earth to learn and to experience what it's like to be alive. Herpes may have came into your life for your greater evolution. Everything that's happening to you is actually happening for you. Number four is you didn't know until you went through it. You have to forgive yourself for what you didn't know until you went through it. You didn't purposely get herpes, so don't be so hard on yourself. And now you're on the other side. Now you have this big opportunity to be able to like connect with other people. And if you want to, like share with other people, share about like, man, like this happened to me. Like I never saw that coming. And it was hard for me to accept. And it was hard for me to deal with. If it was, it was for me. But really just like forgiving yourself and like giving yourself that grace and compassion to like make mistakes and learn and experience life. That's why we're here. We're here to experience it all. And you got to experience herpes. Some people experience things that you're happy you never had to experience. And I'm sure there's some people that are like, I'm happy I never had to experience herpes. But like we all have things that we're dealing with, that we're experiencing that other people may never get the chance to. And when it comes to herpes, it's like, because no one talks about it, we often can't even like connect with each other about our experience about herpes. And that's why I love support groups. And that's why I love sharing about herpes and connecting with you guys. Like I love it when someone adds me on Instagram and we get to connect. And it's just like this real raw level of connection. It's like this layer of connection. It's such a bonding moment. Number five, don't take it personally. A lot of our suffering stems from our taking things personally. So when I say don't take it personally, I'm talking about so many things And this is hard. I'm sure you've heard that like how someone speaks to you has way more to do with how they're feeling on the inside than actually has to do with you. Hurt people. I guess if we're talking specifically about herpes, don't take it personally, can mean a lot of things. It can mean if someone says something mean to you, or if you disclose to somebody and they make a choice for their own sexual health that they don't want to continue your sexual relationship or whatever the situation is, it's like, try not to take that personally, because a lot of suffering happens in the human mind, and it's when we decide that it means something to us. It's when we internalize it. It's when we take it personally that we really suffer the most. So this is just a friendly reminder to use herpes as a teacher to guide you in your journey, to get curious about yourself, to bring you closer to who you truly are. And nothing happens in this life that you can't handle. You can handle herpes. You can handle anything that comes along with herpes. You got this. And if you're looking at me like, yo, you're so brave, how are you talking about herpes openly on social media? I just want to tell you that like, if you can share with one person, you can share it like I'm sharing. There's a scale for sharing, and like there might be opposite ends. At the end of the day, like you have a greater purpose. You're on earth for a purpose. Your presence on this earth makes such a difference. And I just want to say that if you're interested in going from shame to sharing or anything in between, I do have a one-to-one herpes personalized program that you can learn more about and apply for on my website. I would love to talk with you about it. If that's something that you're interested in, I would love to help be a guide for you and lead you to this freedom of being able to accept yourself and not have something like herpes hold you back, and actually use it as fuel for your future and for your growth. So thank you so much for listening. In the words of Brevin Roth, if you made it this far, you might as well subscribe. Comment down below, message me on Instagram, like this video. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later.